at the periphery today, a group of exercises to work on the foot core, the muscles that go on the foot, which tend to be weak quite often, and they are very important for nice and healthy foot, but they can also help you if you're suffering with plantar fasciitis. So these exercises, we don't need much. I believe you want to have a spiky ball or a massage ball or a tennis ball. But other than that, we just need a mat, or you can do this also on the floor, on the carpet. It's very easy to follow. So I'll be demonstrating the exercises on my right foot, but you could be doing them on your affected side, or if you wish to work on both sides, that's fine too. So with the ball ideally, or something that you can use like a ball if you don't have a ball. First thing we're going to do is a bit of a massage, which is both to stimulate a little bit the plantar fascia, but also to release it if those muscles are being particularly painful. So I just want to try to release from the ball of your foot all the way to the heel, and you can just go all around the base of the foot, kind of a bit of foot here and there. Just trying to keep yourself a nice deep release. And you want to do this maybe 10 times, 15 times, depending on what time you've got available, what feels nice for you. So once we've done our release, then we can leave the ball or whatever we used as a ball aside, and we're going to try to work on lifting the arch of the foot. So we'll try to do just think as if you could kind of shorten or lift the arch of the foot without using the toes. So just notice I'm not doing that. I'm trying to get the arch to move, but create movement from the arch itself. So sometimes that, yeah, we'll tend to do that using the toes. We don't want to. Toes might move a little bit, but they shouldn't be where the movement comes from. Helps, you could maybe perhaps place a towel or a theraband underneath the arch, but you don't want to think again of just rubbing it with the toes, it's just again trying to create a bit of a lift. And we'll be doing this again about 10 times, 15 times if you've got time, and potentially enough. Then the next one we're going to do is going to involve a little bit of the toes. This you could do sitting. I'm going to do it first sitting and then I'll do it standing, so you can see the front of my foot as well. So we're going to try to disassociate the big toe from the rest of the toes. So for this, we'll try to lift the big toe independently from the other toes, and then do the opposite, drop the big toe and lift the other four toes, and then repeat this again. So lifting the big toe, and then dropping the big toe, lifting the other four toes. And we'll repeat again this 10 times. But thinking of one repetition as both parts of the movement, the lift on the big toe, then the drop, and the lift of the other four toes. I'm just going to repeat it one more time in the waves, and then I'll stand so you can see it maybe a little bit better. So if I'm doing it standing, it's easier done if you're doing it seated. You can do the same, lifting and dropping it. Perhaps on the back you can see it better. Hopefully you can see that a little bit. It takes time to practice, but it's a really good exercise for the foot. Then the next one I'm going to show you also involves a little bit of dissociation on the toes, and it's going to be, it's like a waving sort of motion from the toe. So we're going to try to start from the little toe, then going to the right toe, to the big toe down, and then lifting up one by one back to the toe. So from the little toe down, from the big toe up. Can I follow this video on it? Picture your toes, you like the roots of the tree, and you just want to keep the roots on the ground properly, with the idea of kind of separating the toes a little bit as they go down. And same as before, you can do 10 repetitions, thinking of one repetition as moving both ways, yeah, kind of down and up, from the little toe to the big toe, and from the big toe back to the little toe. And I'll show you again perhaps look slightly easier from this angle. And as I said, it takes concentration, takes practice, but it's a great exercise again. It helps you get your foot a little bit stronger, because you can like our core muscles. In the center of the body, we've got a foot core as well. Great. So once you've done those, it would be nice to release a little bit your calf and stretch a little bit the calf. So we can do guinea pig cord, your release ball, massage ball, or a spiky ball, or a foam roller. That would work as well. You could just use it for a bit of massage in the calf, so you can just slide a little bit forwards and back, trying to apply a little bit of pressure with the feet again releasing. And you could do again maybe 10 times or so. I'll do 5 repetitions forwards and back just for time purposes in the video. Now once you finish the release, we can just finish by taking a calf stretch. I'm going to show you on 4 minutes, but you could be doing this if you've got a TheraBand or your usual way of stretching your calf. It's quite nice if you just extend. So the leg you want to stretch, you tuck all 5 toes, and you can just gently push back with your body weight to stretch it. And this might give you a bit of a stretch also on the Achilles tendon. You might feel a little bit the plantar fascia, the sole of your foot is stretching, which is quite nice. I'm just going to repeat it one more time, but you could do again maybe 5 to 10 repetitions, holding it for a few seconds or staying on this stretch for a bit longer. You could hold it maybe for 10 to 20 seconds. So these are a few exercises and stretches and release work that you can do to help your foot if you're experiencing plantar fasciitis, but also if you want to work on your foot core. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please subscribe to my channel. If you've got any other suggestions for any content you'd like me to work on, please send a message. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that I will see you in my next video soon.